My name is Pedro Molina. I am currently working in Financial Force as a technical support. Well, my company is we're Salesforce partners. We have over 650 employees, and we have offices around all the world. Our head office is based in San Francisco, which goes to the Salesforce building. Well, we do have also more offices, like Taiwan in Harvard in UK, and where I'm working in Granada, a really nice office actually. So you want to say something else about the company, Paco?
Hello, my name is Paco. I'm working for Russian Force with Pedro, the same thing in the support team. I would like to talk with you about that. We are in a recruitment process now. We are hiring people. We are hiring people in all our offices in the different locations. And especially in our case in Granada, we are recruiting from this year 30 people. The next year, we are recruiting more than 50 people. If someone is interested, please contact us. Thank you.
Okay, but we're not here to talk about ourselves or to talk about our company. We're here to talk about access security. Well, every time I'm getting a new software, new tools, something new in my job, I'm asking myself the same question. What can I do with it? How can it help me? Sorry, it's gonna be easy to set it up. Well, all those questions are questions that we're gonna try to answer today. But if you go now running to your org and you go to your setup and type transaction security, you're gonna maybe find yourself like our friend Vincent Vega, like, hey, what is this? This guy was pulling my leg? What is this stuff? Well, it's not like this, okay? This is because transaction security is coming within a bigger package. It's coming with a Salesforce Shield. Salesforce Shield also will give you some other security tools, really, really useful, but to get it, you will need to buy it or to be subscribed to the Salesforce Shield Event Monitoring add-on. So going back to our question, what is transaction security? Well, transaction security is actually a feature that will allow you to take real-time actions. And we're talking about security and real-time actions. For me, this is quite important because every time in the past when I was working in other systems, what I do have was a huge log from the server with a lot of information about what my users were doing, but the day before, not right now. And well, this will allow you to take actions for it right now, all right? But maybe you're gonna now be thinking, but this is gonna be complex to set it up because it's gonna make me to do some jobs, triggers, for sure Apex code. Well, that's not true, all right? Because we're gonna try to show you that transaction security is really easy to set up. Just with few clicks, you have something really, really handy. So going step by step, transaction security or transaction security policy that you might find also like called like this in internet, is a set of three big keys. An event, a real-time action, and an Apex class. Well, the events you will be monitoring actually are four. I read somewhere that Salesforce is working in one more, but I know you have just four: the login, entity, data export, and the access resource. Those events are actually Salesforce objects, all right? So you know that the Salesforce object is something with more information. Like for example, the login will give you information about what user is logged in role, or the entity will give you, which is actually quite similar to the login, but will give you some more information like from where is this user logging or accessing to your org, or what IP is using, something that you might be find useful. The data export will allow you to check if someone is exporting information from your org. Yes, we'll be looking for some standard objects, but it's still handy. All right, it will give you also information about if the user is using external API, inside API, or the standard Salesforce. And the actual result will give you information about the connected apps your users are using and the reports and that sort of thing. Well, the second key will be the real-time actions. You can see that this is split in several sections. Alright, so you have the action that you won't find all the actions for all the events, but pretty much are gonna be the same. The basics are to do nothing. You will be just receiving maybe an email, and the user won't notice you're monitoring his actions. Block the user action, and the user will receive the typical message like, your action has been blocked by your administrator, or something like this. Run a two steps authentication, you know, the typical thing that suddenly is popping up in your phone, asking you for the second step authentication, or end the user session. You, of course, can send an email to an administrator or to any key user, or you can show also the app notification to your administrator or to whoever you have set a source event. And also you can send the user that is running this policy, all right? And the last thing will be the apps plus. I know I told you that you don't need to type anything, and well, this is true because this Apex class is automatically generated by Salesforce, alright? Of course, you can do it more complex, you can add more ifs, more conditional to filter whatever you wanna do in here. But what you cannot do is add DML code in here. But it's still really, really handy, trust me. Okay. Well, I want to show you now a demo, but first of all, I want to give you a couple of tips or tricks in here. Because imagine this situation. I said one of the event was the login, and one of the action was end the user login. Okay, so imagine myself going for the first time to one of these transfer security and setting up a transfer security policy like end user session when this user is trying to access into the org. Okay, I have a trial org. I just have one user, so let's use my user. What do you think that happened? Well, this was actually my face when I realized that I just have ruined my org because I had just one user and I can no longer log on it. It's not a big problem because it's a trial org, but you're still losing whatever you have in this org, all right? Also, if you want to take a photo from these links, our working links, I have just shortened it. From my point of view, are really, really handy. The most will be the examples that are piece of code made by Salesforce that will help you when creating your transfer security policies. All right, so let's go for a quick demo. Okay. So you can find the security in the trailer. So in that you won't be like Vincent Vega, all right? So as I said, it's really, really easy. You have just to press in here to create your policy and a few steps. Okay, let's check the data export. You can select here any of those objects. For example, account export. And now you can select to generate an Apex class or to pick up any Apex class you have already in your log. So I have prepared this, I will show you later on. Okay, the actions. And you see the data export have not all of the actions, but for example, let's block the user when it's trying to do something. Okay, this will be the recipient of the email that we want to send. And the user who is running the action will be also myself because I have just one user. Okay, so let's call it. Okay. Well, this will be Sadie, but I have this other here. The double tips I said before I was going to give you is one of these is this one. So please double check if you have security policies already enabled, and also check what you have selected to do with the transaction security and with the user. Okay, this one is selected. The Apex policy is just checking that you are trying to load over two records. So if you just try to load one record, you will be blocked. But otherwise, you will be able to load the records. Okay, we have just seen here one. Okay, we'll be able to say just one, but we'll try with two. Okay, we will block it. This is the necessary.
The presentation it has two parts. One is from Pedro, transaction security, but both are part of Salesforce Shield. And my part is Event Monitoring. Event Monitoring is a tool that is a feature that Salesforce has in order to identify what is happening in a. If you think before in something that we could easily understand, is imagine a detective who is using magnifying glass looking for clues, go to the place where someone stole something. These kind of things that he is using to find what We're going to talk a little bit about introduction, a little bit about query event log file, how to download this event log file, the different event types, and we are going to talk about report export, the example that Pedro mentioned before. The last part is we're going to briefly to talk about web analytics and event log file. Event monitoring is a feature that Salesforce includes information about operational events in your system. This information is stored in the event log file. Information like event type, log of day, this is information that you could find if you go and access to the MLO file. It's an internal object in Salesforce. New event types are available each new release in Salesforce. For example, in Winter 18, there are new event types that there were not before in the previous version. There are more than there are more than 30 different types of events. These kind of events are for everything: login, REST API, everything. You can monitor in your org everything if you use Event Monitoring. I would like to stop here to say something very important. This is a feature that Salesforce has, but you need to pay for that. That means that if you want to have your logs, you need to pay an extra cost for that. By default, for example, developer orgs or the partner orgs, you have everything. But if you are a customer, you need to pay for an extra cost. Depends your contract and all this information. If you have an enterprise, if you want to have all the events with 30 days of rotation, taking account if you I was talking about that. If you want to have the event log, you need to pay for that. Depends your contract, maybe it's included or not, but it's something to take in account. If you are a partner or a developer, you have this. If you are a developer, you have free access to like, but only one day retention. And if you have enterprise and limited or performance issue, you have only login and logout. If you want the rest of the events, you need to pay for that, or maybe call with your account manager yourself to do it. The event log file, there are some different tools that we can use, for example, Robage, to know the information is included in the event log file. If you see there, for example, we have to assess it using SQL, and we see an example that there are three event types of API and one from Abbott's call. This tool is used for that, for example, but you can use as well using the REST API, and I will give you an example here. There is another tool that you can use to extract the information of the event log file. This tool is Salesforce Event Log File Browser. It's a tool that you connect with your org and has an interface a little bit better than Workbench, and you are able to download using CURL or Excel file, and you are able to see like you see here the event type, for example, Apex execution, what or the ID of the org, the user ID that was doing that event type, etc. Event types different. If you see there is a list of event types, there are more. After the release of Winter 18, there are some more that are not here. I marked in red reports for the example that Pedro mentioned before. But if you see, there are a lot of them. It's very useful. It's a tool that for the admin people and support people we could use, because sometimes the problem that we find sometimes in our team is we find the problem at this point of time, but we don't know what happened at this point of time, and with that tool we will be able to know that information at least a little bit, what Apex execution was happening, if someone logging in the access in the org, or someone download something or whatever. This is the part that I mentioned before. If you see an example in the report, for example, these are the fields that you can see, for example. People, for example, are able to see the event type is one of them, or is, for example, the ID of the report that the you are exporting a report description, but you have another more, like IP, the organization ID, time, etc. There is a document where you can find every single type with all the information that you are going to see. And for the demo, I am going to mention, I'm going to show you, I'm working now in how it's integrated with the new application, but you are able as well to take the information from your role and export it with analytics and see what is happening. For example, this is an example that different users that exported a report that is just that part, and the other IDs are the
future.
Okay, I'm going to do a short demo.
Now, if you want to get it back, okay, if you want to import it here, you can even do that. So one solution is many people say, okay, I want to run my reports on first of every month. I want the data every day. What they can do is, you can archive it outside on the day one of every month.
That is happening there. If you see the Workbench, we are able to run. For example, if we run this select,
$700 annual cost, and S3, this is the file storage mechanism, which is stored on database.
We are able to see the different elements. It's a little bit difficult to run.
If you bring the CRM on S3, it starts a lot of money. Both are given by Amazon. And it should be $1,000 for the simple development of one job.
Select. You will be able to see that, for example, for today, I have done a report from yesterday. I cannot. We are able to see that. But this is not very good. It's only the information. There is another tool, WordPress Explorer, that people use, for example.
Yeah.
This
query. My organization, we work for 50 GB.
And I execute here, you will see that we are able to see different records in a best way. If you see here, this is the ID of the record, for example. You have a better way to see the information of the available log. If you see, this is the record that we were using.
How do I need to schedule my job? Is it like daily or hourly or monthly or programming language. Many are comfortable with Python, and many are comfortable with
this is the same ID.
Salesforce provides language
for it. Okay.
So you can pick it up. And
many users
are running machine learning algorithms.
I will show you a little bit as well the Salesforce Evelog web browser, how it works. You connect to the OR. And for example, we can play here with the different events that we have, as you see here. For example, at the end, you see the way. And I'm going to look for the report export, for example. And I'm going to look for the last 30 days. on the fly, and we are able, clicking here, see, and let's start with CSV file with all the columns that you can see here, the user ID, the client IP where I'm doing, the word align, drawing, a lot of information that you were able to identify here. This tool gives you this information. And this is an example of the information that we have exported in the Salesforce event browser. We have take analytics and we are managing. With the new tool that we have in, that is, there is a license of application Salesforce web application that you will have some templates that you cannot do, you don't need to create from scratch. This part is complex and need to have more time to do that. And that's all from me. Thank you very much.